My name is Debbie Zagone, and this is my husband, Mike.
Mike.
And we are from Albuquerque, New Mexico, in the United States. October 28th of 2014, I was in my car. All of a sudden, it was like some shutters were pulled on my eyes. I could barely see enough just to pull off to the side of the road. I pulled off, I sat there for 10 minutes, I felt okay. I went home. Everything was fine that evening. The next day, I had a small headache. I drove myself to the emergency room, but apparently I stroked in the MRI. After they got me back to the emergency room from the MRI, I stroked again. I ended up 3 days in the intensive care unit. And then from there, I was transferred to a rehab center in Albuquerque, where I stayed there for 49 days.
39 days.
Was it 39?
39, yeah.
Okay, a long time. It was too long. Where's my makeup artist and my hairdresser? My voice is raspy. I lost my peripheral vision, loss of my left arm, left leg, and I cannot open my hand. I was a very independent person. I have no freedom. How we found out about Beike was Mike's investigation on the internet, and then I kind of picked it up from there. And I found Beike has a wonderful stem cell website that gives you all kinds of information, what to expect, what they can do for you. They don't make promises that they can't keep. On the website it says day one, day two, this is what will happen, day three, day four, you will be provided this. They were very good about laying everything out on the line and not trying to candy coat things.
Yeah, I never thought that she would just get stem cells and then just pop up, you know, like new. And I was just hoping it would be more of a, you know, get her going again.
Since I have the stem cell, I'm able to see some peripheral vision, which I was not able to see before. My legs are getting stronger. My upper body core is stronger, and I have more confidence. I am more independent now since I was 3 weeks ago.
She can stretch her arm more, she can lift it more, she's way more flexible than she was in her upper body here. After she kind of went through her rehab, on the left side, both right and left eye, there's about a 30 degree field of view that was cut off, so kind of tunnel vision to the left. And right after the first spinal stem cell shot, I was in here on her left doing something, and I know where she would normally not even see me. And she started telling me what I was doing. And I've tested her several times where I'm doing stuff, and I ask her what I'm doing, and she could see me, where before she wouldn't have even seen me at all. How are you doing?
Good. When we first got here about 3 weeks ago, my left hand was in, my thumb was tucked in like this, and it was in a knot. Now, I can raise my hand. I'm able to open my fingers and pull on it. It's not 100%, I know it's not, but it's going to be some work to do that. The trick is repetition, repetition. The feeling in my left foot has improved drastically. When I first got here, you know, when your foot falls asleep, that's what I had, no feeling. Now, after the treatment that I have received here, I can feel the nubbies.
She was never able to feel that.
I was never able to feel that. And this has just happened within the last day or two. So I think physical therapy and also to the stem cell, I would attribute to that. When you are getting ready to stand, make sure that your feet are parallel they talk about your posture. Before I got here, they had me wear an AFO. It's a brace that went up over my knee.
It supports her knee and her ankle. And they discourage her from using that here. So it's kind of difficult because without that there, she couldn't really walk.
Well, since I've been here with the therapy, they're concentrating more on building my muscle so that my left leg or left knee does not hyperextend. This has given me renewed hope and strength inside and a new insight as to what I can do now and how much further I can go just with the hard work once we get home. So here I take one foot and go over. It will be hard work, but I would much rather live my life using the muscles in my legs and not dependent on something that isn't natural. There are other ways to do this, and then you just sit down slowly. Now to get up on the bed, scoot back, and then you can hang on here. Keep your feet together, and then slip them over. Coming here, I feel like my whole life has changed. I personally wish that I could have another 2 weeks to a month of therapy here at this hospital. That's how much I feel that the services that they have provided have helped me in so many ways, not only physically, but mentally. And I would jump at the chance for more stem cells in a heartbeat. I think the quality of my life will have improved probably at least 90%. So I think once I get home, there's no stopping me. Just talking to my children on the phone. They have expressed, they said, "Mom, you sound so much better. You're speaking so much better. I can understand you. You sound like your old self." And to hear my grown children say that they're hearing their mother like she was years ago, that they feel like they're getting their mom back. So that's always nice to hear. I didn't want to Skype because I don't want them to see me in between. I want them to see me after I'm done with the program, because I plan on greeting my children and my grandchild with a cane and walking to them. That's my goal with the next couple weeks when we get home. So I want them to be surprised. I want them to tear up with happiness.